Hi, everybody. My name is Jen Smith. I'm a 52-year-old transgender, or whatever you want to call it. There's all kinds of names floating around out there. I'm staying on this topic of transgender bathrooms or transgender access to bathrooms and change rooms. I'm calling this video the Transgender Bathrooms Jedi Mind Trick, or How to Brainwash the Women of the World. They've been using social engineering and social control strategies for a very long time to manipulate people. And we've gotten to a point in society where the use of Hollywood, the media in general, print press, any sort of means of mass communication, they've got their grubby little paws on and they are messing with people's minds all the time. This is social engineering, or what I like to call Jedi mind tricks, which gets us to the subject of this video. So what is a Jedi mind trick, and how does it relate to the whole transgender bathroom agenda? Well, let me explain that for you. Some people may not know what a Jedi mind trick as a phrase refers to. Well, it refers to the movie Star Wars, and in the movie Star Wars, there's sort of like this old mystic named Ben Kenobi, and he has sort of like psychic powers where he can basically control other people's minds. So there's one scene in the movie where they're Ben Kenobi and the hero of the movie are traveling and they get stopped by the evil empire. And they have in the back of their cruiser a couple of robots that the empire are looking for.
How long have you had these droids?
About 3 or 4 seasons.
They're up for sale if you want them.
Let me see your identification.
You don't need to see his identification.
We don't need to see his identification.
These aren't the droids you're looking for.
These aren't the droids we're looking for.
He can go about his business.
You can go about your business.
Move along.
Move along.
And that's basically what's been happening now with the transgender agenda. I'm not completely sure about everything that these social engineers are up to, but I know them, okay? I know them. If they're watching, I know you guys, right? So, how does a Jedi mind trick work with transgender bathrooms? Okay, well, I'll tell you how it works. Okay, so what we've seen here is, in previous videos, I talked about how Caitlyn Jenner and many other of these fascists out there are suggesting that people shouldn't be able to ask questions of transgenders. Specifically questions like, are you a male or are you a female? That's supposed to be a taboo question to ask a transgender person.
She issues a kind of social warning, saying this is a topic only a transgender person can bring up, and the rest of us should never ask.
You know, so and I would make a suggestion to all people out there, don't ask the question. It's not an appropriate question to ask.
They're actually where I am trying to get sex identifiers removed from all identification and to basically make it a crime to ask whether somebody's a male or a female. And what they want to do is they want to get it so that public washrooms and change rooms, anybody who, for instance, identifies themselves as female should be allowed to go into the women's washroom or the women's change room at the local pool. And nobody should be able to say anything about it if they identify themselves as female. Sensible people, especially the women in society, take an aversion to this, right? So they don't want men going into the women's change room at the local pool and, watching their 8-year-old daughter getting changed, or brainwashing, specifically, I think, the women of the world, because women have always been the ones that have protected our children, okay? So the most important thing to do is to brainwash the women of the world. And they do that in the following way. So why would any mother that cares about her 8-year-old daughter want to allow somebody with male genitals to come into the change room where they can watch her daughter change or take a shower? Why would any mother agree to that, right? Most mothers wouldn't. So how do you get them to agree? Well, here's how you do it. Jedi mind trick. What you do is you say that, oh, these transgender women are all in danger if they go into the men's room. They might get raped or beaten or something like that. They'll just ignore the fact that it almost never happens, but they'll probably wheel out a couple of what psychology calls vivid examples, right? Isolated cases, and they'll play that up to the max, and they'll stick it right in your face. So they'll show, look, it's terrible. What happens to this transgender person when he, she went into the men's room, got leered at and threatened or beaten up or, you know, whatever, some isolated case. And they'll throw that in your face. So it's loosened you up a bit there. And then what they'll do is they'll wheel out some cute little harmless looking transsexual, like this one. Or they'll have a whole group of transsexuals like that one that are all so, you know, small, timid, and cute, and harmless looking, and they'll say, oh, well, isn't she cute? And they'll have her, like, cooing like a dove or something, and they'll say, it's okay, you can pet her, she's sweet and harmless, and all the women will go, oh, isn't she sweet, and she seems like she's one of us, and she's in such danger, sure, she can come on in with us, right? What they don't do, right, what they don't tell you or show you is that once you open up that change room to that cute, cooing little transsexual dove, you also get these guys coming in. So they don't use those guys in the press conferences and stuff and any public relations that they do because it would be too honest. Because there's a whole bunch of different types of transsexuals out there, from the cooing little dove that they like to wheel out for you, to these great big sort of manly transsexuals, all of whom, or most of whom, will have their male genitals intact. From my experience in the transgender community, you'll find that most of them are bisexual. Okay, so those two big lug transsexuals that you saw there at the end, you can't stop them from going into the change room. You sign up to let in the cooing little dove, and then once she goes in, these other two come in behind her. And they're going to be watching your daughter change too, maybe showering with your daughter. So that's a Jedi mind trick, right? They never bring in the two big lugs. They never talk about that. But when you are asked by government whether or not you support transgenders being able to use the female washrooms and change rooms, and be very careful, because when they talk about bathrooms, most adult women are thinking, oh, well, that's the women's room at the local pub, right? No, that's not the way it works. It's any place, like the pool that I used to go to a lot, the washrooms were located in the change rooms. But that's how they do it. That's the Jedi mind trick. That's how they brainwash the women of North America. They use the little cooing dove. Everybody goes, oh, she's so nice and sweet and pretty. Yes, of course she can come in, right? But that's not what you're going to get. Okay, because you can't discriminate based on how somebody looks. You can't say, oh, well, only people under 5'6" can go in, and only under 130 pounds, and only if they're pretty. You can't do that. What you're going to get is these bigs. I know personally transgenders who are like 6'2", 240 pounds. I mean, back in the 1970s, there used to be this trick where you'd be driving down the road and you'd see some pretty little girl on this teenager or whatever on the side of the road hitchhiking, and you go, "Aw, look at that poor, sweet, beautiful girl. She needs a ride." And you pull over, and she'd come and she'd open the door, and then, you know, her giant lug of a boyfriend would jump out of a ditch, and he'd get into the car with her at the same time. Or maybe two giant lugs would get out of the ditch and get in at the same time. And that's exactly what we're seeing happen right now. People sometimes ask me, why, as a transgendered person, are you protesting allowing transgenders to be able to use whatever washroom they like? Why would I do that? Isn't it self-defeating? It's not self-defeating, okay? A long time ago, it used to be really well understood in our community, okay? It used to be really well understood that the best way to get yourself killed was to deceive people. Let them think that you are something that you're not, okay? Now we've got this culture where these little brown-shirt fascists don't want to have to admit what they are, don't want people to know what they are. I admit who I am. I'm expressing myself in a legitimate way, and we've just gotten to a point in society where I can do this without getting beaten up. So I'm very glad that we've reached that point of tolerance where people are allowed to express themselves this way. But I don't support any sort of deception. And I don't support allowing those big lugs or me into the little girl's change room at the local pool. I would rather put myself at risk in the men's change room than put those little girls at risk by opening it up to anybody who identifies themselves as a female that wants to go into the women's change room. And I also don't support deception. So they're worried that if they go to the gender neutral bathroom that people will be able to know who and what they are. So what, right? Or if they go into the men's room, that it'll be obvious who they are. Again, so what? You know what I do when I go into the washroom at, say, the casino, and there's men in there? I just wave, say hi, right? It's no problem. Do transsexuals get attacked and beaten up? Sure. Every gender has that happen to them. Old people, young people, males, females, transgenders, of course they do, right? It doesn't happen very often.
It is an offense to real women, especially to those that have been subjected to male violence and rape, who now have to put up with previously legally protected safe spaces being opened up to anybody claiming to be a woman, whether they look like one or not. But Trudeau and Trump apparently like that idea. People tend to think that this is just a liberal idea, but it's not. As this clip from Donald Trump makes quite clear, he is another person that supports opening up women's spaces to males who identify as women.
No. I really don't know. I probably do. I really don't know.
So if Caitlyn Jenner were to walk into Trump Tower and want to use the bathroom, you would be fine with her using any bathroom she chooses?
That is correct.
Okay.
It needs to be understood in our community that the best way to get yourself killed was to try to trick a guy, right? Or to not let a guy know who or what you are. And now we want to institutionalize the ability for people to do that and tell people it's okay and brainwash them into thinking that people with male genitals are real women. They're not real women, okay? I'm not a real woman. I embrace femininity within myself. That's an internal construction. But biologically, I'm male. And whether you're talking about the cooing little dove or the two big lugs that I showed you earlier, they're all male biologically, too. So change rooms and bathrooms should be sex specific. Females, males. If you have male genitalia, you go into the washroom that's for males. If you have female genitalia, you go into the washroom and change rooms that are for females. You could have something that's gender neutral. Okay. That would be okay. But, you know, too many of the little brown shirt fascists are worried that somebody will know what they are. Why are you worried about somebody knowing what you are? Why? Own who you are. Be who you are. Go into the men's room if you have male genitalia. Go into the men's room and do what I do. Hi. I don't get attacked. Okay? attacks are very rare, but when they do happen, of course, they'll plaster them all over the news because they're on this social engineering kick right now, right? Don't let them brainwash you. Okay, women of the world out there, don't let them pull some guy out of the ditch when you're thinking that you're picking up a cute little girl on the side of the road. Don't let them pull that guy out of the ditch on you. And if somebody like Justin Trudeau or Donald Trump or Barack Obama, any of these leaders out there, is some, especially Justin Trudeau, he's got to be like the worst for this, you know. And I voted for Justin Trudeau too, so I'm really disappointed. He's one of the worst ones for this, okay? If he's not going to come out to you and present this honestly, demand that it not be put through. And there are activists out there who want to make it illegal for you to ask. We know that women, that females, are sexually assaulted multiple times, like many, many, many more times than males are. So we need special protections for girls in place. And that means no male genitalia in the girls' change room. I support that, right? I'm willing to put myself at risk going into men's change rooms and men's washrooms. What about the rest of the transgender community? Do you people have courage? Or are you all cowards that want to shift your danger onto the little girls? Just wanted to alert everybody to the Jedi mind tricks. You can see that clearly being used in this transgender washroom thing right now, and other transgender issues. They're messing with your mind all the time. They're doing it on television and the TV series, and they're doing it in movies, and they're doing it in the press, and it's coming out of government halls and stuff like that. But it's not just with transgender issues, right? I do it all the time, right? This is what I studied in university. I know these vampires. I know them. I know them well. I know exactly how they roll. It's time that everybody knew how they roll. Okay? And women, don't sit back and be silent. Okay? If you don't want those big lugs, if you don't want male genitals in the little girl's room at the pool or in women's change rooms and stuff, you're allowed to say that you don't agree with that and you don't think that's right. Okay? It's good to be tolerant. Right? It's good to be tolerant of me and say that you support my right to do what I want and express myself as I want. That's very good, right? But you don't have to subscribe to stupidity. If they come out with something like this, saying these big lugs with male genitals should be able to go into the shower room with your little girl, it's okay to say, no, that's not all right, okay? You're not going to be intolerant by doing that, okay? I don't want to go in and change with your little girls, and you shouldn't be letting these other people do it either. And beware of the Jedi mind trick, right?
You don't need to see his identification.
Don't ask the question.
These aren't the droids you're looking for.
These are not the trannies you're looking for. Look at the little cooing dove.
He can go about his business.
Don't let them use that little cooing dove to deceive you. I want to protect our community. Don't listen to these propagandists at the top of the advocacy groups and at the top of the humongous financially rich LGBT groups and the politicians who are all corrupt and have other stuff going on that should concern you. Don't trust these people. They've never been trustworthy, okay? I'm part of the community, and I want what is best for us. And what's best for us is to either use those gender-neutral bathrooms or go into the men's room. And remember, if you go into a gender-neutral bathroom and somebody knows what you are, who cares? That's what you are. That's what I am. Nobody can do anything about it. Own it, okay? And don't be deceptive. Don't try to set up systems where deception becomes the modus operandi. Because when you start deceiving men, okay, young transgenders out there, pay attention. When you start deceiving men, sooner or later that's going to come back to get you. In the past, that's resulted in transgenders being murdered, okay? That used to be understood in the community. You don't deceive, okay? And that's what this any bathroom you want thing is all about. It's about deception. Okay, it's not about protection because transgenders hardly ever get attacked in bathrooms. Although if this understanding was to go out into the public, you know, the advocacy groups might stage a few assaults just to make people more pliable. But remember the two big mugs. I have our community's best interests at heart when I'm saying this. People think that I'm a traitor or something for saying this. I'm not. I believe this is what is best for us. Say no to transgenders going into any bathroom they want. Okay? Leave it up to businesses to decide whether or not they want to create gender-neutral bathrooms. They should not be forced to pay for that, because especially small businesses can't afford that type of thing. And if they can't and it's not available to you, just go into the man's room. Say, hi, when you go in there, what are they going to do? Beat you? Rape you in the men's room? Not likely. So just own it, right? And try to get over the nerves and learn to accept who you are and tell the world who you are. That's the next stage, right? The next stage is not blending invisibly into the community. The next stage is everybody learning to be who they are and let everybody know who they are. Okay? That's the next stage. So please, if you're transgendered, join me. Support me. You know, tweet this video out. Put it on Facebook. Share it with people. Do whatever. Let's get the transgender community out of this brown shirt fascist culture that's emerging, where they want to shove everything down people's throats and deceive everybody. Let's stop that right now. Let's let them know that we're open and we're honest and we want to work with them and we respect the right of their 8-year-old daughter to be able to change at the swimming pool without some big lug coming in there with his male genitals and watching or changing with her. Okay, we respect that. We respect the right of women to protect their children in that way. Let them know that's what we're about. Let them know that we're not brown shirt fascists who want to force them to do everything and prohibit them from asking any questions. For me, it's like, go ahead, ask me questions. Am I a male or a female? Go ahead, ask me. I'll tell you, I have male genitalia. Right? I have a male biology. I express myself as a feminine being, but I have male biology. I'm more than willing to admit that. Okay? Everybody should be willing to admit that and never try to deceive. Never get into this program. I mean, I see this everywhere with young transsexuals. They're always hiding who they are and then complaining later that when the guy found out that I was transgender, he wasn't interested in me. You should have told him right away and saved everybody time. So let's develop a culture of honesty and respect. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll be making another video relatively soon. I have some other important issues to talk about. Probably the most important one is the indoctrination of children that's going on in our schools and why that's a bad idea. That'll be one of my next videos. So until next time, bye. No.
somebody else's shoes. I don't really know why some do the things they do, but I can understand what so many have been through. I can feel the urge to belong to something new, and I don't wanna listen to another sad story. Don't wanna be deceived with tales of false glory, and all these legends in their own mind bore me. I'm not distracted by the glitz that's before me. I can see the discontent that plagues you. I can feel the stress that moves to break you. I can sense the dread that overtakes you, and I can hear the chains that bind and claim you. But something isn't right with the hamster on the wheel. Day has turned to night, now the servant won't kneel. Peasants wanna fight, they refuse and they yield. What the devil's going on, can anyone reveal? Though I don't have the faintest idea why people even here. I don't believe it has to do with salaries per year. I don't believe humanity is floating on a sphere, so that you can wait to live until retirement appears. And I'm just talking straight as I can steer. Society, a bunch of crazy bastards over here. So puppets and your masters, you can find me over there, where I'll be patient waiting for your madness to clear.